In this video, we are going to look at the creation of work axis features in Autodesk Inventor. The axis tool is here in the work features panel on the 3D model tab. I can click the drop down arrow next to it and see several different ways to create work axes. We'll look at most of these right now. I'm going to skip over the plane axis here and jump to on line or edge. Very simply, I can just pick an edge of a part and it's going to create a work axis for me. So here you can see I'll do that again, work axis. There's a work axis. So pretty simple there. Next, I can create a work axis parallel to a line through a point. For that to work, I'm going to need a point. So I'm going to switch back to the point tool and I will place a point at the midpoint of this line here. Next, what I want to do is I want to create a work axis that's parallel to an existing edge or axis and runs through that point. So I'll choose parallel to a line through a point. I'll choose the line it's going to be parallel to, and then the point it's going to run through. And now you can see I've constructed a work axis there. Next, we can create a work axis through two points. So for example, I can pick maybe the top right corner of this box and the lower left corner. And now you can see that a work axis has been constructed right through this box. Another method for creating a work axis is at the intersection of two planes. Now obviously if two planes intersect, they already have an edge. But in this example, let's look at this triangular cutout. If this face were to continue up, and so would this one, they would meet at an edge. So we're going to find that edge by using that work axis option. Intersection of two planes. I'll select the first plane, then the second. And now you can see that it constructed a work axis up here in space where they would have intersected if they extended to meet. The next option we will look at is normal to a plane through a point. So normal basically means perpendicular. So perpendicular to a plane through a point. So here I have this pyramid and I want to create an axis that runs straight up through the middle of the part. So I'll choose normal to a plane through a point. So it's going to be normal to this bottom plane, and then it's going to run through this top point here. And now you can see that it constructed an axis that runs vertically up through that part. Finally, we'll look at a couple of circular options. We can create an axis through the center of a circular or elliptical edge. So for this one, I'll just simply click on a circular shape, and it'll create an axis that runs through that center. Similarly, if I undo this, if I were to choose the option to go through a revolved face or feature, I can just click on the cylindrical shape itself and it will create an axis that runs through that cylindrical shape. As with the point tool, you can actually just click the axis tool itself and then the type you create is just contingent upon what you click on. So therefore, you don't have to choose the specific options. You can just choose the axis tool, and whatever you click on is going to determine what type of axis is created. That concludes this lesson on creating work axes in Autodesk Inventor.